Welcome, Rangers, to the end of the week. We've all made it. Before we finish up, we've just got a couple more updates just for you to listen to. First up, I'd like to invite up Millie, who's the coordinator of AMSA's most amazing and impactful project, Vampire Cup, to come and tell us about the competition this year and how you guys can get involved.
Good afternoon, lovelies. My name is Millie and I'm the National Coordinator for AMSA's annual Blood Drive Vampire Cup. Now, I must prepare you. Vampire Cup is a competition between each medical school and it is as hotly debated as the Bachelor. But fear not, whatever the outcome of this battle, I can assure you that you will be someone's type. You guys have the superpower we need. War is imminent. However, in this bloodbath, lives are saved and they are not lost. Each donation can save 3 lives. But as I like to say, each donation can also create 100 of smiles, and that power is absolutely priceless. Vampire Cup this year will be running from 24th of July to 17th of September. You can earn points towards your uni by donating whole blood or also by making plasma donations. To sign up, there are 3 very simple steps. 1, you must book an appointment or talk to your local rep about organising a group appointment. 2, fill in a Red 25 form so that your donation counts. And 3, go to a centre and donate. Okay. So I had a lot of fun this week being part of my UNSW EMC team. And I can tell you, over time, we stand in our pretty sexy Superman and Superwoman costumes. And my team leader, Mary, says, let's activate the massive transfusion protocol. And I am grateful that we have some stellar superheroes in the background have given their time and their blood to save the lives of others. Please roll up your sleeves, and if you are like me and unable to donate, fear not. You still have the power when you encourage your friends and your family to donate, and proxy donations do count. Now, I will leave you to enjoy the rest of your day. But please get excited, because this year, Vampire Cup is going to be very exciting. There will be many prizes to be won, including Threadbow Day vouchers. And when it comes to Vampire Cup, I just leave you with one question. Who will be the bloody champions of 2017? Thank you.
Before we finally wrap up, it's that time, Rangers. You've all been competing all week. It is time for us to award the All Hallowed Convention Cup.
We've reached the end of a long, long week, but all too short all the same. So we've come to thank you for getting amongst it during the week. All of the things that you've participated in contribute to the Convention Cup points. So now I'm going to announce who the winner is. So just a recap of all the previous Convention Cup. Will it be one of the ones who received the Convention Cup in the past, or will it be someone new? Will it return to the city of Sydney? That is the ultimate question. Before I announce the winners, just wanted to make some honorary mentions. Firstly, to Jack Ashley of Western Sydney University. Who on Monday, I believe, was at the Vodafone shop when someone had a cardiac arrest, and so he used his EMC skills and performed CPR on them. Is that right? Yeah? Big round of applause to Jack. Second is our fearless leader, Scott Ashby, who was fed his anaphylactic trigger of peanuts the other day, managed to survive another day, and then even came to the social last night and was on call. So 500 points to Scott Ashby as his own university. And then some spud points were deducted for some interesting dietary requirements. As logistics said, fuck your dietary requirements. So Monash Griffith, for I think it was ketogenic dietary requirements and also liquid carbs, and Rob Cario for breast milk only. So thanks, Rob. And finally, some of these points were deducted and also given prior to this week. Special mention to Sean Anthony, who in the process of registration managed to click the button 3 times and paid a total of, I think, almost $5,000. Yay, Sean. Now to the winners. Special mention to University of Otago, who with only 2 delegates managed to acquire 525 points. Huge achievement. Woo! In third place on 955 points is, drumroll, University of Melbourne. In second place on 985 points is, drumroll, Western Sydney University. And in first place with 1,030 points, thanks to their EMC points, is the University of New South Wales. Well done. For the first time, we have a new award. Unfortunately, quite ironically, we managed to lose it in the back room. The inaugural Coffeefe Spud Award goes to a university who acquired 45 points, and that's Deakin University. Once we find it, you may pick it up from Rego Desk or at Gala Ball, but that is a snapshot of what it should look like. All right, thanks, guys.
So, Rangers, what a week. Before we look back on the experience that we have had, I'd like to take a moment to thank a few people again. Firstly, I'd like to thank our sponsors, in particular BOQ Specialist, RACGP, and especially the AMA. Secondly, to all of our portfolio teams, those guys that you've seen in the light blue shirts that have been running around behind the scenes that have made this week possible. Can I ask everybody on one of these teams to stand, please? Can you all join me in giving a very sincere round of applause and a sincere thank you to the people that have made this week happen? Thirdly, I'd like to quickly thank the AMSA National Executive, in particular Rob, the lovely Helena, our events coordinator, and the wonderful Maddie Taylor. Yours is a pretty thankless job, but we wouldn't have made it without you. And I'd also like to throw in thanks to Tom Morrison, the chair of the board, who's been a fantastic support and help throughout this week. Lastly, thanks to all of you. Thank you for getting amongst it and making this event what it is. It's been really lovely meeting all of you, or a lot of you, throughout this week. Thank you for coming up and saying hi. And I hope you've had just as much fun during this week as we have. Now, it's time for us to take a quick look back on the week that has been. But while we do that, we're going to take a look back a little bit further. We're going to look back around 18 months in a little bit, in a few of these scenes, to see what the process of putting this event together was actually like.
I'm looking for a place to start.
All good. I'm Scott. I'm the convention convener. How did you feel when you got the role? First thing I felt was nervous. It's a big job and I was scared that I might not be up to it.
The best parts of medicine that I ever signed for, the most important things, like ambition, competition. And so we had like three kind of things. So it was like expose people to a bunch of amazing ideas for people, to give them more human focus, so to think outside the science. And then lastly, to like bring that all together into like a cultural change.
Having to see how excited people
are, how much it means to people. I'm feeling pretty excited. Pumped. It's gonna go well. Okay. So much excitement to go, and I've already fallen in love with the other people on the colours in disguise.
Running into the So I think the song that would best describe these feelings is probably Bohemian Rhapsody. Just a few highs and a few lows.
A reggae beat with Bob Marley, Don't Worry, Be Happy. As the soft walls
ease.
I was excited, but I was daunted and really nervous at the same time, which kind of hasn't really gone away. I'm still pretty nervous and I feel like I'm making it up as I go along, but hopefully it'll be okay in the end.
Sydney Convention Team. You are not only inspiring, hardworking, and extraordinarily talented, but you are also a family, and I adore you all, and I'm so proud of what you've brought to life. Can you all please join me in a sincere thank you to the people you see in front of you that made this week happen? Before we finally finish up and pass over to the next team, we've got a really exciting presentation for you. I do just have to point out our convention team MVP, Amanda Zhao, our amazing secretary. You have gone above and beyond again and again to hold this project together. You are simply wonderful, you're a joy to work with, and you're also one of my closest friends. Thank you for all of us, this convention MVP. And I think, Rangers, that is a wrap. I'm looking forward to seeing you all at the Gala Ball tonight, but before you go and you sink into some post-convention depression, we've got the Perth team to come with an exciting presentation for you as well.
We're not the Perth team, it's okay.
Did you have it?
No.
No, I gave it to you.
You too, then. I might have it in my pocket. Thank God.
There wasn't even a rub and ash thing.
So clearly we have the most important and final thank you left. Ever since Sidvention was a mere thought, we couldn't have even imagined doing it with anyone else. We speak for Amanda, Idy, and the rest of the team when we say we appreciate all the hard work, the countless sleepless nights, the hours squinting at Adobe Premiere, and the endless negotiations with ICC.
You've been a confidant, a cheerleader, a referee, and occasionally the one that tells us things aren't possible and brings us down to earth. And I'd probably say you're the first convener who's actually almost died in the efforts of making a convention. Like, actually. This has been a very special convention for me. It's my last one. And as I hope many people have told you over the week, it's definitely been a ripper week. I feel after being at 7 conventions, I have some authority to say this. It's probably been the best one. Not biased, guys. And without you, Scotty, this wouldn't have been all possible. So we would like you all to take your feet and join us in giving a true ranger thank you to one incredible giant.
Thank you, Scotty. And now for the Perth team, guys. Get excited.
What a week Sydney has been. Can we all just take a moment to thank the Sydney team, the national exec, and all the AMSA reps and presidents for the phenomenal convention that we have just had. And thank you to all of you for being here and making convention the event that it is. Your passion, your playful enthusiasm, and your variable levels of promiscuity is what makes convention the greatest student-run event in the world. My name is Sid, and I am the convener of the 59th AMSA National Convention in 2018. Convention is swapping coasts and flying over to the other side. That's right, convention is coming to Perth. Of course, as we've just seen, organising an event like this is definitively not a one-man show. And so it's my pleasure now to introduce to you the Perth 18 family. This clicker doesn't work. What do I do? We're going backwards, going forwards. Oh, there we go. Yes. Progress. Someone help me out. It's the green button. I'm pressing the green button. There we go. Deputy conveners, Brian and George. Treasurer and secretary, Ruby and Tim. Our academic conveners, Harry and Jesse. Creative officers, Mike and Yang. Our logistics conveners, Adash and Danushka. Some of you might know that Nush is also the treasurer of WOMS. Our social conveners, Josh and Sarah. Our sponsorship officers, Gavin and Marissa. Our sports day conveners, Bree and Matt. And our IT officer, Jess, and risk management officer, Sylvia. These guys are the finest conveterans I have ever met. And I, just like you, cannot wait to see what they produce because I know it will be incredible. But now, the moment we've all been waiting for. A little teaser for you.
I've been up all night, no sleep, 'cause I feel like I'm always dreaming all night, no sleep. That's how it goes. But ever since you came around, can't nobody hold me down. You showed me how to find myself when I needed it the most. I've been up all night, no sleep, 'cause I feel like I'm always dreaming all night, no sleep.
Now, in classic convention tradition, we are about to give away one guaranteed registration to Perth next year. To explain how we're going to give away this guaranteed rego, I'm going to read you a little poem. This poem is titled Guaranteed Rego by Jess Perring. To win guaranteed rego is no trouble, so follow these steps on the double. A number you must pick, only one will do the trick, so listen up now or you'll struggle. Between 1 and 100 it will be. Go find our website and you will see. Click on Guaranteed Rego, but you'd better move presto. The first one to guess you must be. All right, Rangers, get your phones out. I want to see your phones lighting up the auditorium.
Are we feeling ready? Link's about to go up. Ready, set, go. Or not. There we go. We have a winner already. Do you want to read it out?
Okay, so our winner from the Australian National University, and the number was 59, because it's going to be the 59th convention next year. And the winner is Belle Detail. Well done.
Congratulations, Belle. To everyone from WA, we'll be expanding our convention team in the coming month. So if you're interested in being part of the larger Perth 18 family, stay tuned, we will be in touch. For everyone else here, make sure you grab an envelope on your way out. We've got a couple of treats for you. See you tonight, Rangers, and see you in Perth in July. Remember, today is not goodbye, it's just see you on the other side.
We don't have